Video for class 12 computer science student. In this video we are going to discuss about concept of object oriented programming. Object oriented programming, it is also known as OOP concept. So we are going to see what is OOP concept. Now in this OOP concept there are five important features that we are going to see in the chapter, but before that, when we start, we want to see what is object. So any entity which has some specific characteristic and property, it is known as object. So generally in programming we used to create classes, and for that classes we create objects. So object is a entity in programming which has some characteristic and some property. We will see later on what are objects in detail again. Now we have to see what is class. So class is a collection of similar type of entities or objects. So we can say that it is related to objects. Group of similar type of object is also known as class. So in this OOP concept, these two things, classes and objects, play a very important role. So we will see in this chapter what are these all five OOP concepts. Now we have to see one by one what are the different OOP concepts. So firstly, there are five in number. They are encapsulation, also known as data encapsulation. Second is data hiding, that is abstraction. Third is inheritance, polymorphism, and modularity. There are five major OOP concepts that we have to see in this chapter. Now one by one we are going to see what are they. Now before we start, we take one example. Here in this diagram you are able to see that there is a class mobile phone. So it is a particular class which contains data, model, color and price. All these are a common characteristic which belong to this class mobile phone. Then we are having different objects like Nokia Lumia. So it contains some data and functions, different functions, different data. Then we are having one more, Asha series. It contains some other different data and functions. Then i4 or i5, any other objects. So these all three are known as the objects, and this mobile phone is the particular class. So I hope you have understood the concept of class and object by this example. Now what is encapsulation? So before we start encapsulation, we should understand the concept of data hiding. What is data hiding? So data hiding means data abstraction to provide necessary detail to user, and hiding all the unnecessary detail or background detail from the user is known as data abstraction or data hiding. We take one example. Let's suppose you want to drive a car. So you should know all about the mechanism of car, like clutch, brake, accelerator, steering and gear. These all things are necessary which you should know how to drive a car. You should not know about the engine, how engine works, how the fuel convert this thing into that energy. So how, what is the mechanism of engine, that we don't have to understand. So that is hidden from the user in order to avoid that complexity. We use this concept data abstraction. So it is a very important concept of the programming language. Now we see the second concept, that is data encapsulation. Data encapsulation means that data and the method or the function which uses this data are kept into a single unit. That single unit we called as class. So class contains both the thing, that is data and the function also related to same data. So that together represent class. So it is known as encapsulation. That means we have wrapped data and function into a single unit, that is class. So this concept is called data encapsulation. Next OOP concept is modularity, that which we already have used in class 11, that we are breaking big tasks into several small segments. That is called as module, and we are implementing in the programming with the help of functions. So that is called modularity. In order to make the program more simple, in order to split the complexity, we are using the concept of modularity. Now next we are having inheritance. So inheritance is the concept in which one class property is being shared by another class. The class whose property is being shared, it is known as the base class, and the class which shares the property of that particular class and have some property of its own, that is called derived class. So it consists, it has two things, base class and derived class. Here if we see by the same example, so we can take that mobile phone is the main class, and this Windows phone, Android phone and this iPhone are three subclasses which are derived from this mobile phone. It contains all the features, data, model, color, price, but every class contains its own some more feature. So that is called derived class. So here mobile phone is the base class, and here Windows, Android and this iPhone act as derived class of this mobile phone, which are derived from this class mobile phone. I hope you have understood the concept of inheritance. Next in the chapter is about polymorphism. So polymorphism is a phenomena in which one message can be processed into more than one form. So we can say in the easy word, it is also called as overloading. So this concept is little complex, but when we will understand separately, and we will be able to understand the concept of polymorphism, that one message can be processed in different forms, that is overloading, is also known as polymorphism. So generally it has operator overloading, then we have function overloading. It is of two types that we are again going to see in the next chapters. Now we are going to see advantages of OOP concept. So generally these are certain examples which we have to see. Simplicity, that it make one language generalized, it implement the real world. It means we can implement the programming things to the real world by this concept. Then we have modifiability, means it can, we can make changes later on, we can add in the language, so updation can be possible. Then third is extension and maintenance is very easy in this OOP concept. So these are certain advantages of OOP concept. Then we also have reusability and security. So these are advantages. We can reuse the code again and again in different function, different software. Then security also is implemented so that data can become more secure. So these are advantages of OOP concept. Now I hope you have understood this concept, OOP concept, by this video. There are certain terms which you can see on the screen. Again, it's for your revision purpose. Just go through it, then you will be able to understand this all five OOP principles. Thank you.